Hey guys, welcome to another episode of free and open source software installation. In today's episode, we are going to install Icarus Verilog and GTK Wave in Ubuntu Linux. Together, this combo is very useful for the beginners in VLSI domain to practice Verilog simulations and waveform viewing. Stay tuned till the end of this video to get ready with these simulators. Hey guys, welcome back to the computer screen. Today we are installing two most used softwares for a VLSI beginner. So here I have opened the URL in browser. Today I will install these two. First one is Icarus Verilog. It is a Verilog simulator. It's a binary, and GTK Wave is a GUI. So here you can see the GUI looks like this. Now these two are used hand in hand. Once your Verilog code is simulated, you can dump a waveform file, that is VCD file, and you can view it with the GTK Wave. So this is a kind of flash screen that comes once you have launched the GTK Wave. So here you can see the Icarus Verilog. It's a Verilog simulator. I will provide all these links in the video description. So from there you can pick it up. Just now, let me show you a few things. It is also available in the GitHub. From there you can download. Today I will install these two in my Ubuntu system, and those are basically command line. The instruction will be there in the video description. So instead of searching here and there, you can directly go to the video description and from there you can find it. And here you can see that this particular Verilog simulator is a part of the GNU EDA, that is GEDA, and Icarus Verilog is the part of it. And GTK Wave, it is very essential once after you run the Verilog code. Another link I'll also provide in the video description. This is the wiki page where GTK Wave details are there, and this is for the Icarus Verilog. So here you can see the Icarus Verilog. There is an installation guide, user guide, developer guide, glossary, everything is here. So I'll also provide this for your easy use and can use it like a manual and so. And GTK Wave, this also I'll provide you so that you can go there and dig up by your own. I'm done showing in the browser, so let's now jump into the command line. I have captured the install instruction here in a text file. All this data will be available to you in the video description. Now, so let me now add this particular repository first. So I add this. I have to give the sudo password. I have given the sudo password. I have given enter. It started proceeding. One essential thing I'll tell you here. I have connected my machine to internet right now. To install like this, have to have the internet connection with you. So the first step is done. Let me now do the second step. The second step is also done. Now I will install two binaries. First, the Icarus Verilog, that is binary name is iVerilog. When you are installing and when you are using, you have to use this binary. So here you can see it started installing. I have given the instruction here. So I think this is done. Now I will give the instruction for the GTK Wave. Now the GTK is getting installed. This is also done. So the installation of the Icarus Verilog, that is iVerilog binary, and GTK Wave are done now. In the video description, I will also provide the install links or the URLs where you can get the Windows binaries. Let me do a ls here. I have kept a Verilog file here. Let me open it with the gvim. So here you can see there is a D flip-flop circuit here, and here is a small test module, and here you can see I have done dumping of the VCD file. I'll not go in the architecture and all of this example. I'll just use this case to demonstrate how the Icarus Verilog works and hand in hand how the GTK wave is used. I am doing the ls. You can see there are only two files here right now. One is the instruction.txt, which we have the details of the install instruction, and the second one is the mydiff.v. I will run the Icarus Verilog. I type iVerilog, then I give the Verilog file name. Once I execute this, I have executed this and there is no syntax error like that. And you can see once I do the ls, here a a.out is created. The Verilog code is compiled by the Icarus Verilog, and by default it creates a a.out and it's an executable file. So we have to do the execution of it, and you can see I have given the name a.out. Once I execute, I have given a display statement here inside the test module, and from there you can see this has been printed out. Now let me clear the screen, and again I do the ls. You can see one more file has been created. This is the VCD file. VCD means value change dump. Now how I open this file? I will use GTK wave. Then I give the ampersand sign, is basically used just to disjoin the window from the terminal. Otherwise the terminal will be kept occupied. So once I type, you can see the splash screen has come. Now the GTK wave has been opened. Let me maximize it. And here at the left, you can see here, once I click, this data structure is there. Now, if I click here, you can see these are coming, which are basically the data from the Verilog file. Now, if I click, you can see there is a clock signal. It is going periodically. Then we have the D pin, we have Q, we have the reset one. Here you can see that entire timing diagram as per the test vectors is shown here. So this was the installation episode, and I have covered the basics. That means how to install and how to use the basic things. So that's all, folks. Thank you very much for watching up to this point, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. In case you have some dislikes, put that as in words in the comment section down below.